Well, Madam Chair, I did have a question for Senator Jungbauer, but to this particular point, and I was trying to scroll through to see if I had. I had gotten recently an email from, I think it was the Fordham Foundation, where Chester Finn, the former Department of Education official in the, I think, the Reagan administration, and also a good friend of our friend Mitch Perlstein, he wrote a history of and a description of tenure that I wish I would have thought to bring it with me today, and I could have shared it by what I can make. I've got a hard copy of that in my office, and I'd be happy to make a copy and bring it. But as I recall, his point was that judges have tenure. That's constitutional. University professors have tenure, as Senator Harrington pointed out, for protection of their ability to speak frankly about issues.
Academic freedom.
Mm-hmm. Academic freedom. But tenure in the K-12 system is relatively new. As I recall, his point was that it was something that was instituted relatively recently. And he was calling into question the purpose that we would have to have it, and I think raising some of the same concerns that Senator Jungbauer in his bill is raising. And I frankly share those concerns. I think that we've talked somewhat, and I know we're going to talk more about teacher evaluation and how do we make sure we have effective teachers and how do we do that. And there's been some proposals. I've talked to some of the folks interested in this and devising what I think might be a fairly complex structure to devise standards and to implement standards on what effective teachers are and how do we make sure those standards get disseminated and people in school districts use those standards and, you know, evaluate teachers. And it occurs to me that if we created an opportunity for schools to periodically make decisions on teachers, we wouldn't have to do all that. That they would have a very strong self-interest to decide whether or not a particular teacher should be kept, and they would be compelled to come up with some way to evaluate that would help them answer the question whether it makes sense to continue the contract or continue the employment of a particular individual. So I think to the extent that we're interested in finding ways to make sure teachers are evaluated for effectiveness, I would almost prefer that we not be in a position of deciding what effectiveness is and then writing a bunch of rules and trying to find ways to make those rules happen at the local level, but instead create a condition that encourages local districts to do that. And you might get some variation, I agree, from district to district on what they decide is effective teaching. But it might be a lot easier to effectuate. It might be a lot easier for them to execute. So I support the bill. I did want to have Senator Jungbauer comment a little bit about, and he and I talked somewhat about this before he came to committee, but the portion of the bill that deals with the school board's role in deciding on contracts of individual teachers. And I just, Senator Jungbauer, if you wouldn't mind just talking a little bit about that provision of your bill and how you understand that working and why that approach is in your opinion, the way to go. I have some question about it, and I just want to give you a chance to talk a little bit about that.
Senator Jungbauer.
Thank you, Madam Chair. And Senator Hahn, thank you for the question. Again, members, I want to make it clear, I'm not sure that this is the best way to handle it, but today there's no affirmative vote on that continuing contract. And so I looked at trying to keep all politics local. I think the school board, I think Senator Hahn made some good points that I don't want to tell somebody, here's the performance standards. I actually hate the fact that the federal government's involved in education, and I think we micromanage it down from there, but I think that school boards should live and die by their election certificates just like we do. And so I thought to keep it local was to have the school board make those affirmative votes on those continuing contracts. Again, open to other ideas, but Senator Hahn, I like the idea that we should not be writing the performance standards. I think it should change from district to district depending on what are they trying to accomplish, how do they feel their teachers need to move into the next generation of knowledge to get that knowledge base to the kids in that district. So.